Good day, dear students. I'm again with you. Today we are going to speak about communication psychology. Communication psychology is the science of people's interpersonal communication with each other. The materials in the section on the communication psychology prove that the interaction between people is impossible without communication. So, in order to exchange information, we need communication with each other. And in this very process, in this very aspect, we are going to speak about the secrets of psychology of communication. So what is psychology of communication? Every successful person and developed personality cannot live without communication. Here, we are going to speak about the successful communication skills. So man is a social being, so communication is an integral part of his life. With communication skills, we can adapt to society. In order to have a successful communication, the first of all, the communicant should know the purpose of the communication. Why are they going to speak about? Why are they going to exchange information? The main thing, in order to have a communication skills to be succeed, you have to give attention to the purpose of your communication. Here is the main point of a successful communication. Many communications have got three basic purposes. The first one, to inform or to explain. Second one, to request or proceed. And the next one, to build goodwill. Especially the main purpose of each communication is to inform the listener about something, about some issue. Some other purpose of communication can be establish goals or develop some kind of plans to effect the change, organize human being or some kind of event, select, lead, direct, or control the performances. It doesn't matter what kind of purpose the communication has, but you should have very good communicating skills in order to achieve your goal in communication. So this competency and other purpose of communication like obtain and share the information, build goodwill and image or proceed, build relationship and self-esteem. Then further, we're going to speak about the next steps of how to build good communication skills and how to develop your communication abilities. But here, we can see different kind of purposes given by different kind of scholars on the screen. According to psychologists, any communication cannot begin unless there is a reason for it. And before beginning, you need to ask yourself why. As soon as you answer this question for yourself, then you will understand the principles of building future dialogue. And you have to choose the strategy and the tactics for building communication with your partner. Communication by goals can be the biological or social, and by means direct, just the sense of participants, and indirect using some means, direct personal contacts and indirect communication involving second parties. According to psychologist Lomov, the speech communication is divided into three main levels, which we can discuss with them in the first hour slides. So I just told you about the three main communication levels. The first one. So they are macro level. The analysis of relationship between the individual and the group is carried out. That means the major groups are participants of this level. Meso level, medium groups are main participants. And last one is a micro level, minimum units of communication, which are considered as a question and answer period. So if we revise one more time, there are meso level, macro level, and micro level, which you can see on the screen. Meso is a medium system, macro is a large system, and the micro, it is a small unit of communication. After my lectures, you can look through the PPT and this video and again revise all the three levels of communication. Thank you. According to psychologists, there are several components of communication. They are exchanging the information, exchanging the actions, and perception and evaluation of the partner. So it doesn't matter which component of communication you are. The advisors are following advices. Ability to speak correctly. In order to communicate successfully, you should clarify your speech. You should speak very clearly that they should understand what you are saying. And this is the first secret of successful communication. And the next one is control your negative thoughts. Formulate your thoughts. In order to avoid this, you need to formulate your thoughts correctly, using your voice timbre, tonality, emotionality, and other qualities. And while you speak in a tone that alters, sometimes it may affect the communicant negatively. And that's why, in order to succeed in communication, give attention to the tone of your speech and your thoughts. The next one is mutual understanding. In communication, you need to be able to be as clear and expressive as possible, because it is as much as pleasant to communicate with a person who is open and goes to a dialogue. And that's why I try to create mutual understanding, to create mutual understanding atmosphere. Here below, we are going to speak some secrets about successful communication. Here there are tricks that are used and very used by famous speakers and orators. Here below, we are going to tell about some of them. So let's begin. So the first one, the Benjamin Franklin effect, is considered extraordinary and unusual person who was able to manipulate people. So, by politely asking him to borrow something, he thus guarantees a favor in return. And that's why, shortly we can say, using politeness in your speech is the success of communication. Use polite words. Use politeness always in your speech. The next one is mimicry. This concept is based on the fact that copying the gestures and facial expressions of the speaker whom you are speaking to. And this is psychological research suggests that the people tend to sympathize with those who look like them. And that's why, while they speak, try to repeat their actions, their facial reflections, and so on. And always try to call them by names. Names are very important, and they sound very pleasant for a personal speaker. And that's why, while addressing, while applying to a speaker, try to call them by their own name, and it sounds pleasantly. Next one, ability to listen. Especially, you should have ability to listen to your listener, because when you speak, you can express the respect to him, to his sorrow, to his ideas, to his problems. And that's why the famous orators or speakers advise us to be able to listen to the speaker or just the participant of the dialogue, and it will affect the communication positively. The next one is rephrase. Rephrase what the other person told you. This is one of the main guarantees of the building friendly relations. Or you can paraphrase the phrase you have just heard as a question from your friend or from your listener or the speaker who is standing in front of you. This will affect it here as you are giving attention to his words, to his phrases. Now we are going to speak about anthropophobia. So what is it? Especially nowadays, people are afraid of speaking in front of public. They are afraid of speaking or making a speech in front of people or audience. It is called anthropophobia, fear of speaking in front of audience. And what kind of way out can we advise for these people who are afraid of auditory? The main reason for the anthropophobia of communication is low self-esteem, the presence of negative experience, and the lack of communication experience and skill. Don't forget, low self-esteem is for losers. And that's why, stop just having a low self-esteem for you. Don't be afraid of people. Don't be afraid of audience. Prepare you psychologically
and try to develop communication skills in yourself. So, what should we do? Having determined the reasons, we begin to eliminate them. First, you need to understand and realize the presence of fear and look at the situation from the outside. And accepting the information about the presence of fear will always allow you to start working on the problem. And that's why work on your speech. Do some exercise in order to develop communication skills. So here, work systematically on yourself. So you can achieve success only if you have a confidence in your voice, ease in your behavior, a sincere smile on your face, and a sense of complete inner calm. And that's why try to work on your speech and speaking. Try to be confident and try to use facial expression or smile on your face and the complete inner calm you should exist in your soul. In this very case, you can have some successful communication results. And try to follow this advice several times a day in your daily life. Here below, we are going to speak about some techniques such as observation, improving your communication skills, expanding your horizon, and the ability to restrain your personal emotions and recognize the mood of your opponent, and know and observe the principles of etiquette and norms accepted by society. And here below, we are going time by time speak about each of the issues. And here, we can continue about this one. So, as a lot of people want to be understood, heard, and recognized. All of them want to be heard, understood their problems. And that's why, while speaking to them, try to listen their problems. Try to listen to their abilities, their problems, their issues. And with verbal and non-verbal communication, you can achieve success. So try to use your facial expressions, gestures, intonation, emotions in order to succeed. So in order to improve your communication skills, we advise you to communicate more with people, with strangers, with your friends, with teachers, and so on. In order to develop your communication skills, you should have speaking in practice and strangers at all. So you can not only develop your communication skills, but also overcome the fear inside of you. And that's why the practice makes perfect. Speak, communicate, and exchange information. The next advice is expanding your horizon. A person who knows the latest news, a lot of useful and useful ideas, and knows how to present them correctly will always have interlocutors. So it means if your horizon is wide, if you expand your world of view, you will have more friends, more communicants. The next one that we are going to speak about, controlling your emotions, and or otherwise they will control you. What does it mean? Try to recognize the mood of the other person. Try to control your emotions, your facial expressions, as well as give attention to the mood of the other person. According to his mood, you have to choose some kind of way out, or just you can find a way to his heart, to his soul. If he is angry, and if he is sad, if he is happy, according to this, you have to choose a strategy. Look at their face, look at their emotion, try to observe them. If they are happy, try to choose another word. If they are sad, restrictive words. And that's why, in order to succeed in your communication, observe the mood of the speaker. That's the main point in succeeding in your communication. In order to succeed in communication, try to be friendly, try to create a friendly smile on your face. And these are the fundamental factors of communication psychology. So that was all for today. Thank you for your attention. After my lectures, you can look through the PPT and video again. And if you have any questions, you can ask anytime. Thank you very much.